Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Today we're doing the fourth and final drawer in my eyeshadow palette collection. These are all the high-end eyeshadow palettes, so let's get started. This one here is actually not a palette that you could like just buy like this. These are just shadows that I've kind of stuck in here. This is the Makeup Forever eyeshadow palette, like the metal, it's like a Z palette. And these are just some random shadows that I've put in here. So this isn't really technically a palette, but it does have some high-end shadows in there. So that's why I keep it in here. Then we have a Laura Geller Beauty. This is the Cream Glaze Deluxe palette. And it looks like this on the inside. The colors are really pretty. Again, I've got, you guys know, whoops, I just about stuck my finger in it. You guys know I love my purples. It does have a mirror up here too. I don't think I've been mentioning whether or not they had mirrors, but I probably should have been. Then we have the the Smashbox Photo Matte Eyes eyeshadow palette. I haven't tried this one yet. This one is one that I picked up during the Ulta sale that they had recently, or not so recently. It's been a while now. So here's what the colors look like in this one. And of course, this does have a mirror as well. The colors are very neutral looking, so should be pretty easy to use. And then we have the Tartist Pro palette. And you guys probably saw a little reflection of me. You guys don't want to see me right now. Like, it's super late at nighttime. I'm filming, so I wanted to get these done before we went on vacation. Here's what these shadows look like inside of here. They're very, very pretty. I totally recommend this palette. I think it's totally worth it. I know some people didn't love it. But again, my opinion doesn't always match what the majority says. I like it. I love it, actually. I think it's a really good one. Then we have the Stila in the Light palette. This is, like, their older style one, so... And then it does have the most famous color in here. It has Kitten, which is the color that everybody loves. I think Kitten is something that, it's one of those classics that you, it's like a casual, or like a well suit. So you know that it's always going to be in style. Then we have the Fiona Styles Multi-Dimensional Color Palette. So this one's got all of your cheek products. I don't know why this is over here. This is in the wrong drawer. So that needs to get moved. Then we have the... Studio on the Go Makeup Eyeshadow Palette, and this one is in Cool Neutrals, I think, or Warm Neutrals, I think. So there's the Warm Neutrals one. I love the colors in here. These are actually pretty good. So I was quite surprised. This came in like a BoxyCharm. And then we have this is the Cool Neutrals, and it's the same company. Oops, I can't open it. It's got a pretty good magnetic closure there, so... These are like the more purpley tones. So if you like the purpley tones like I do, then you would love that one. Then we have the Ciate Olivia Palermo palette. And here's what it looks like. These colors are absolutely amazing. I think Ciate is a brand that's not really well recognized in the beauty community. And I think that their eyeshadows are very, very pretty and they work really well. So I'm in love with them. Then we have the Olivia Palermo. This is the Smoky Suede. The other one was the... Smoldering Eye Palette. So this is Smoldering and this one's Smoky Suede. Whoops, I didn't mean to bump you guys. So this one I haven't really played with as much as I did the other one, but I will be playing with it because I do, like I said, I do really love the Ciate eyeshadows. Then we have the Makeup Forever. This is the Makeup Forever little palette that came in. Pretty sure this came with the, oh my gosh, 50 Shades of Grey collection maybe? I'm thinking that's what it came with. My husband bought me that one year for Valentine. So this came in it. I'm pretty sure that's what came in it. It's really pretty. The eyeshadows are very, very big. And then we have the Makeup Forever. This is the Artist 9. I don't know what this one's called. This is the number 2. So right there, it says number 2. So this is the number 2 palette. And it looks like this. So there's the colors in here. They're very, very pretty. I think the Makeup Forever shadows are very nice, but they're a little hard to work with, in my opinion. Then we have Volume 4. So this is the Volume 4 palette. I haven't played with this one. This one's all mattes. So you'd think I would play with this one first because mattes are like my favorites. Then we have the Volume 3. I think I'm only missing the Volume 2. Or no, the 1. I'm missing Volume 1, not 2. So here is the Volume 3, and again, I have not played with this one. This reminds me a little bit of the Urban Decay Electric palette. I think it's Electric. I don't even know. It reminds me a little bit of the Urban Decay Moondust. It reminds me of the colors in the Moondust palette. And then we have the Tarte. This is the Tarte Rainforest After Dark. It's got that little snake on it. And then the colors all look like this is perfect for traveling. If you want to travel with a palette, these are great for traveling. You've got a blush, you've got a bronzer, you've got a highlight, and you've got you've got some pretty nice eyeshadows in here to work with. So it's a perfect travel palette. The only thing I don't like is that they put the little names on the plastic sheet, so you have to keep it in order to know what the names of the products are. Then we have the Tarte. This is the Rainforest of the Sea. This is the Volume 1 one. And this is the one that I didn't love. So maybe I'll love the Volume 2 more. I don't know. I wasn't in love with it. It made my eyelids look very wrinkly. And I'm like, ugh. I don't want to look older than I am just by putting makeup on. This is the Bare Minerals. This is the Royals palette. How do I open it? Here we go. I think their packaging is pretty cool. It feels kind of like the NARS packaging. So there's what it looks like on the outside or the inside. And then we have the Bare Minerals. This is the Soft and Smoky. And the packaging on the outside of this one's very I think it was like a holiday palette. So there's what that one looks like. Very pretty. I think their colors are gorgeous. Then we have a bunch of palettes in here from Tarte. These are like, I think this was like a holiday set. So you got all of these right here. So this one is the, they're not named. So we're just going to have to open them and see what they are. So this one's got some more smoky shades, like the grays and blacks and things like that. And it does have a little cheek product in here. And then you've got this pink one here. And the pink one's got more pinky purple tones. And then the golden one. And the golden one has more bronzy tones. And it does have a little bit of purple in here too. But then it's got a blush as well. And then here's two more cheek products for our Tarte palettes from like the holiday collection. And these were like a little set. So here's what this one looks like. Again, I don't remember what these sets were. I know it was like a bunch of things you got in the set. And then here is another one. This one's like the purples. This reminds me of the Fiona Stiles one for some reason. It reminds me of Fiona Stiles palette. And then we have the Tarte. This is the Tarte Poppy Picnic palette. And here's what it looks like. I have never touched this palette. That's sad. But I have never touched it. It's really, really pretty. And then we have the Tarte Be Your Own Tartist. So this one I know I've touched because it's got my favorite shades and it's got the purples in here. I love these colors. The colors are absolutely amazing. I'm trying to make sure we're getting good angles so you can see the colors in here. That little plastic thing's annoying. Then we have the Tarte. This is the Tarte Amazonian Clay Eye and Cheek. And it looks like this. This one I have not played with. I love that blush color there. That blush is gorgeous. Look at that blush. So pretty. Then we have the Tarte Tartlet palette. And I have played with this one. Now this one I've played with quite a bit. And you can't really tell though. I think until you start rubbing off the words, you can't really tell that you've played with them a lot. So it's just a really good palette. Then we have the Tartlet and Bloom palette. And this one was like the one that everybody loved. So everybody loves the Tartlet and Bloom more than they do love the Tartlet. Then we have the Cargo Destination Gorgeous palette. This one here is something I'm probably going to pass along actually to my niece as well. This has got a bunch of shimmery shadows in here. I'm not in love with them. It does have a little bit of cheek products and some lip products in here, which again, I don't like lip products in with my powder products. I just don't think that's a good way to do it. My foot is falling asleep, so I need to adjust. Then we have the Pure Cosmetics. This is the Sol Matte palette. Oops. Just drop the brush. It does come with the brush. I've never played with this. Ever. That's sad. You guys are probably noticing that a lot. Then this one is the Pure. I don't even know what this one's called. There's no name on it. I have played with this one. The colors are very, very pretty. I love these bronzy shades. They're gorgeous. Reminds me a little bit of the Urban Decay one. The Urban Decay Naked palettes. Then we have the Cargo Cosmetics palette. And this one is the Land Down Under. So this one's supposed to be kind of like the Australian palette. It's gorgeous. Look at those colors. Those blues are so perfect for the summer. Then we have the Tartlet Tease palette. And it just looks like this. It's just a little tiny little one. Perfect to throw into your purse if you want a little travel palette to take with you. Then we have the Clinique. This is the All About Eyes, I think, maybe? I'm not sure. So you do get some little lip products in here, cheek products, and as well as eyeshadow. So this looks a little bit sweaty or something. What the heck's going on there? That's gross. And then we have over here, we have some Stila products. So we have this Stila. This is the Spirit one. And here's what it looks like on the inside. The colors are gorgeous. Then we have the Stila. This is the Mind. These are all mattes. Then we have the Stila. I love Stila, by the way. This is the Stila body. Look at those colors. Woo-wee! That looks like summer. Then we have the Stila Soul. Look at those. So, so pretty. Now we have the Stila. These are all Stilas as well. These are the Stila Perfect Me, Perfect Hue. And this is medium tan. So there's what the medium tan looks like. I'll show you guys these all together. Then this one is the light medium. So there's light medium. And then this one should be medium deep, I think. Medium deep. No, tan deep. So here's the tan deep. So all together, these, here's how they all look. Whoops. See if I can pick them all up here without, maybe. I'm trying to hold them all. There they are. So there's what they all look like. So this is the deepest one. And then the one on this side here where my thumb is, that is the next deepest. And then the one in the middle is the lightest. So they're perfect for traveling with, though. So if you want a good travel palette, they work really, really well for that. And all the colors, I don't think you have to exactly go by which one works for you. I think you just go by whichever one you're interested in. So if you like them all like I do, then get them all. Then we have the Pure Cosmetics. This is the Daydream palette. So here's what it looks like on the inside. It does have a little mirror inside of here. The colors are very pretty. Then we have the Pure Night Fantasy. This one, look at those colors. Look at that color right there. Woo, I like that one. This one right here looks really pretty too. Then we have the Pure Love Your Selfie palette. And this one looks like this. It does come with lip products and a brow, mascara. So you have that to work with. So it's got your cheek products on there too. Your bronzer, your blush, and your highlight. And then we have the Sigma palette. So we have the Sigma Smokescreen palette. So here's what that one looks like. I have never really played with this one a whole lot. So I need to adjust my lighting. I think my lighting is getting a little bit dark over here. Pull it back a little bit here. Sorry about that, guys. So that is the Smokescreen palette. And then this is the Brilliant and Spellbinding. This one's really, really pretty too. I've not played with this one though, but the colors are gorgeous. Look at that pink and the orange. Woo, I like those. Then we have the Warm Neutrals. I actually purchased this one off of a fellow YouTuber. So thank you so much for allowing me to purchase this. This was a long time ago that I purchased this off of her. Her name is Daylin314. I think that's her YouTube handle. And then I have the Kevin Aucoin. This is the Kevin Aucoin, the Legacy palette. This is an expensive palette, but it's so pretty. I love it. Love, love, love it. So I think it's totally worth the money. I think his products are, they work effortlessly. And then we have the Bare Minerals Nude palette. This one is just okay. I don't really love it. I don't hate it. It's just, it's okay. Then we have the Bare Minerals Be Beautiful palette. And I don't think I've ever even used this. Well, let me see if I can get it out. You guys notice I did put a jacket on in this video. I'm freezing in my room. My room is so cold. Let me see if I can reach the little tweezers here. So you can open it up that way. There we go. If you can ever open one, just kind of pop the top open like that with your tweezers. That seems to really help. So, nope, I've never even used this one. Again. Here's what this one looks like on the inside. The colors, again, are very, very pretty. And then here is the Stila. This is a giant one. It looks like a big envelope. Look at that. That's so pretty. Then you peel it back. It looks like a wax seal there. And you peel it back. And then you open it like this. And then you've got all your eyeshadows, your blushes. And you've got a mascara in here. Ooh, that's my favorite one. See, I need to pull that out. That's my favorite mascara. This is a really awesome palette. That would be perfect to travel with because all the colors that you're going to need, all the blushes you're going to need, you just need some highlight. And that's about it. And some bronzer. Then we have this Makeup Forever one. Let's check how cute this one is. This is like a little suitcase. Isn't that adorable? And then you open up just like a little suitcase. And then you get these little shadows inside of here. Let me see if I can pull the plastic these off. And you get these shadows. Look at those shadows. They're so pretty. I have not really played with this one. I just honestly got it because I thought the packaging was super adorable. Look how cute that is. That is stinking cute. Then the very last palette that I have to share with you guys is a Tarte palette. This is a Tarte. I'm not even sure what this is called. It is the Tarte, the Royal Collection. So this is very, very old. And it looks like that. The colors are really, really pretty. This is when Tarte used to actually make their colors very colorful, I think. I think that they've kind of gone very basic and neutral now. These colors are beautiful in my opinion. So anyway, that is my total eyeshadow palette collection. I'd love to know what palettes you'd like for me to use in the upcoming Makeup Basket Mondays. And let me know, what palette do you have that you like, or which palette in here do you think that I should get rid of? Let me know, because the next process in this will be a declutter. Showing you the collection, and next will be decluttering. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, I'll catch you guys later.